Lever-based controls located on the steering column are mounted about the steering wheel and provide a convenient control mechanism for headlights, windshield wipers, and other various driving mode functions. Traditional designs of steering column controls are implemented using contact wipers and through relay switches in various formats, such as single pull, dual throw. These cantilevered contacts are actuated by the user to set in their various positions and require long-term reliability. When implemented using a mechanical contact wiper, these controls require periodic status checking to ensure the control is still operable, and often may even utilize a wetting current, which helps penetrate oxidation, which will build up over time. The additional circuitry can extend the lifespan of the switch, but when considering the number of controls present in a modern car, this will add a significant number of components and complexity to the overall design. Lastly, the cantilevered contacts will also have a limited number of useful positions. Contact points must be carefully spaced to prevent cases where multiple states are active at a single time. This spacing limits the total number of positions which may be used. Three-dimensional digital Hall effect sensors address all of these challenges. By providing a contact-free solution, which is capable of monitoring very small changes in angular position. When integrating diagnostics, these devices offer a minimalist solution with a great deal of configurability. Texas Instruments' magnetic sensing portfolio provides excellent options when considering position encoding for automotive applications. The TMAG5170-Q1 is a system-on-chip which is capable of measuring all three magnetic field vector components and providing outputs over SPI. Used alongside a rotating magnet, this functionality allows the device to perform angle calculations using the integrated Cortic functionality. With selectable sensitivity ranges, programmable temperature compensation, and other built-in functions such as amplitude and offset correction, this device provides a simple platform which may be customized to calculate angle across a wide array of mechanical arrangements. TMAG5173-Q1 similarly measures the complete magnetic field and communicates over I2C. This device boasts lower current consumption, which, when applied with wake and sleep sampling, will reduce the power demands on the system. Integrated Cortic resolution is 1/16 of a degree. TMAG5170-D-Q1 is a dual die format of TMAG5170-Q1. The die are vertically stacked in the package for improved input signal matching, and the two separate die have independent supplies and SPI pins. These features make TMAG5170-D-Q1 ideal for use in cases where redundancy is required. A replica turn indicator was modeled to fit an existing steering column assembly and to provide turn indicator functionality and flash to pass. The rendered design here shows the turn indicator alternating through all six input positions. The indicator shaft is a lever which may switch about 8 to 10 degrees left or right to trigger the turn function, and from any one of the standard positions, the stalk may be pulled toward the user to operate the flash to pass, which is used to temporarily power the high beam headlamps. The motion of the indicator stalk can be monitored using a single sensor tracking all three magnetic field components, X, Y, and Z. The sensor output data can be used in a quick calculation to provide information about the turn direction and how far the stalk has been pulled. At the end of most turn indicator or wiper control shafts, a knob is present which has some number of stop positions, which are commonly used to set various wiper speeds or headlight options, and a push button is commonly present to toggle modes to spray either front or rear windshields with wiper fluid, or to toggle specialty vehicle functions such as tow mode. This knob has been designed with 10 stop positions and the ability to track button press over a full 360-degree rotation. This rotate and push functionality can be tracked with a second sensor, placed at the axis of rotation. With a magnet mounted beneath the button and rotating with the knob, it is easy to measure the angle with high precision for all positions. To create this demo, an existing steering column module was acquired and then broken down. We can see the cantilevered metal contacts, which swipe across the PCB surface to open and close the control circuits. Similarly, the wiper speed control knob operates using an internal contact wiper to detect each position. Our goal will be to create a functional equivalent using a simple contact-free solution using Hall effect sensors. We also noticed that below the cantilevered contacts is a recess which is an ideal location to mount a magnet for the stalk position. This opening happens to be approximately 12 millimeters by 6 millimeters, so a magnet of this size will be easily installed here. We can use Texas Instruments' Magnetic Sense Enhanced Proximity Tool to quickly evaluate the magnetic field expected for each function. First, let's look at the field produced by the magnet for the turn indicator function. A neodymium bar magnet, which is 12 millimeters by 6 millimeters by 3 millimeters, was acquired, and we will simulate its motion moving past the sensor. To capture the full range of motion in one sweep, the magnet will be positioned and rotated to start in the right turn position and finish in the left turn position. First, we have an animation of the magnet motion, which matches the angular position of the indicator stalk. We see in the results that we can expect the strongest field in the idle position, and that the magnetic field components do not provide inputs that are sinusoidal. Typically, when measuring angle, it is easiest using a sine and cosine with equal amplitudes, and these inputs can be used in an arctangent calculation. Since these signals behave differently, it'll be easier to track joystick position using vector angle calculations, which I will refer to as alpha and beta. As a reference, the method for these calculations may be found in Angle Calculation Methods Using Position Sensor Output Data. The knob portion of this demo uses a diametric cylinder magnet, which rotates about its own center. The sensor is placed on this axis of rotation, and using this configuration, we do observe the sine and cosine field components, which are ideal for angle calculation. When the button is pressed, the magnitude of these field components increases, so it is very simple to track position of both the knob and button together using the integrated cortic angle and magnitude outputs. 3D models were printed to match the existing turn indicator fixture as closely as possible and modified slightly to house the sensors and magnets. We can see the TMAG5170-Q1 evaluation module mounted near the stalk and with the wiper contacts removed. At the end of the shaft, the TMAG5173-Q1 evaluation module has been inserted with the sensor placed at the center of the opening. The button and knob can snap on so that the magnet rotates at the simulated distance. A simple user interface, similar to what might be seen on a dashboard, has been created to pull the data, which is constantly being monitored by the sensors and fed back to the microcontroller, which is connected over USB. Here we see that we can detect the position of the knob. The resolution is clear enough to detect very minor changes in angular position due to the mechanical tolerances of the fit. When the button is pressed, it is simple to detect magnitude changes for immediate user feedback. If desired, a timer function in the controller can be used to give the button both long and short press detection. For the turn indicator position, the X, Y, and Z data is fed back to the MCU, which is able to convert these results easily into alpha and beta angles. When used with magnitude information, it is simple to detect all six indicator positions. When plotting the data captured from the tool, we can quickly see how well the Hall effect sensor differentiates position. First, looking at the results from the knob function, we see a circular plot with 10 flares. Each flare is the result of a button press, and we can count 10 of these as the knob rotates into each seated position. In addition to this, it is also possible to see differentiation of position between each resting position. As a result, the sensor could be used to increase the number of functional positions even further for both the knob and button. If we plot the vector angle values captured using the stalk position sensor against the magnitude of the total field vector, we can observe how easily differentiated the magnet position may be. Here, we notice that as the magnet travels to and from the flash-to-pass position, that we can identify three distinct paths which define the left and right turn positions from the idle position. For this demonstration, it was easy to set up the decision tree for the turn indicator using the alpha angle and flash to pass was determined by using the vector magnitude. To learn more about how to use Hall effect sensors for your lever or steering column stalk design, we recommend considering joystick and lever design with Hall effect sensors, Hall effect sensors for steering column control, absolute angle measurements for rotational motion using Hall effect sensors, or angle calculation methods using position sensor output data. Thanks for watching, and please visit ti.com/halleffect to find more resources and tools.